guys, welcome back. And today, I know that in the past I've been putting up a lot of vlogs, thrifting, buying secondhand stuff, unboxing things from Japan. But since we are nearing the end of the decade, I thought that I would do something a little different. I'm not sure if I've done resolutions in the past, maybe, but I'm pretty sure not in the last 2 years at least. So I thought that I would tell you what are, like, I have five resolutions for 2020 that I want to do, and I know I can do because I have done it in the past, so it's just a matter of me going back to it, okay? So I've actually written it down, and if you follow me on Instagram, you would know what they are. So these are things that, well, the decade is already closing, 2019 is almost over, and a new decade is about to start. So I thought this coming January would be the best time to start over. Now, I've told you in the past videos that my goal before the year ends is for me to be debt-free and to have my credit card canceled. So on Black Friday of this year, November 29th, instead of going shopping, I actually used the money that I saved up to pay for my outstanding balance on my credit card. So that has been paid off. And today, as I'm filming, this is the 9th of November, I have just gotten confirmation from my bank that my credit card has been canceled. So I cut that thing. I've cut it into two pieces. So that's one goal that I have been able to achieve earlier than I thought I would. So I told you before that I was going to do an update video on that when I talked about getting real about my shopping addiction. Now, I am by no means over my shopping addiction. It's an addiction. It's called an addiction for a reason. So it's not something that you can just, like, let go off immediately, but there are some things that I can do for myself that would help me with this. So I wrote down five realistic and doable resolutions for 2020. Okay, the first one is something that I have neglected for the last probably 2 maybe 3 months. I have not been keto in the last, I would say the last 3 months. I've been eating however I wanted to, and like saying that because I'm stressed, because the new job is stressing me out, and like work-life balance is not there, and I'm unhappy with the new job. It looked really good on paper, it seemed awesome to be working from home, but after doing it for about 3 months now, it just doesn't feel right. Okay, and that's what's, it's been causing me some anxiety, it's been stressing me out, and in return, I'm taking it out on food, which is another addiction. So, I'm gonna be restarting my low-carb life with the intention of getting back to keto in the long run. And I know that I can do it because I've done it before. So, it really is all about discipline and getting my triggers out of the way. So one of the things that I've done is to actually delete my Uber Eats app and my Domino's app so that I don't end up ordering takeaway or pretty much junk food. Okay, and what I'm also gonna start doing is write up a list when I go to the grocery store so that I don't end up in the chocolate section. Yes, so that's resolution number one and how I intend to do that. Resolution number two, this is more of a fitness and health kind of thing. As you can see in the back, I've got here my bike. So I've actually bought a stand for it so that I can use it as a stationary bike and like do spinning even at home. But let's be honest, I haven't been doing that. And because summer is here in Australia and it's gonna get really warm, it's gonna be difficult to be outdoors in the heat, okay? So what my next resolution is, is for the month of January, first 31 days of the year, I'm going to do a 31-day dance challenge, which means I'm going to be dancing every single day of the month, okay? Regardless of my mood, just here in my living room, right? I'm just going to be watching a YouTube video of Zumba, okay, and dancing along. I haven't even thought about like how long I'm going to do it, probably 20 minutes at the very least, every day, to get me back into the rhythm of exercising and moving, because working from home has left me even lazier. I thought that if I started working from home, because I'm not going to be commuting to work, I would have more time to go to the gym. But it's not about not having time. It's about having the motivation and the discipline to go to the gym. And I just don't have that shit. So I'm challenging myself for the first 31 days of the year to just move. Just move. And the best way I can think of is to dance. Because I do like to dance. I'm not very good at it, but I have some rhythm, and if I have somebody to follow, I pretty much can do it, okay? So that's what I'm gonna do. Dance every day of the month in my living room, regardless of what mood I'm in, okay? Even if I'm in a crappy mood, it's probably gonna pick up my mood, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do it. Number three, and this has to do with that five mistakes video that I've done about when I started thrifting. And this one is, I've noticed that I keep on popping into thrift shops, and I do it more often now that I'm working from home because I have so much time. Instead of heading to the gym, I go to thrift stores, and even if I don't need anything, even if I don't want anything, I will find something, and I will justify the purchase because it's cheap, and I'm giving that item a second life, and I'm preventing it from going into the landfills, I'm helping the environment, yada, 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 yada. So many excuses and so many reasons why I should buy something that I don't need, and I look at my closet and count the number of shoes and bags and clothes that I have, and I'm like, there is no way I'm gonna be wearing those clothes every day because I work from home. Like, when do I ever go out? On the weekends, if I do. So there's no reason for me to have all these things, really. So I'm going to stop popping in to thrift stores unless I'm actually in need of something. Like, there's an actual gap. I'm not gonna use it as an excuse, or I'm not gonna go there because I'm bored, or I feel restless, or I feel like I need to get out of the house, or whatever. Whatever the reason is, like, unless I actually need something, and by God, when I look at my closet, I think I would never have to go into this thrift shop, okay? Justifying a purchase just because it's cheap and sustainable is still consumerism, okay? So I may have stopped shopping online and going to the mall and like wasting away my money impulsively, but I'm still consuming so much, and because it is more affordable, because it's thrift, because it's secondhand, because I feel good about buying something and giving it a second lease on life, I have now become addicted to thrifting that I don't need to do. Okay? So I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna stop popping in unless I have to. Okay? And by that I mean maybe I need to buy a gift for somebody, or something in my closet has broken or can't be repaired anymore. Those are the only reasons. Okay? Number four. I'm gonna declutter. I have this anxiety now, and I feel overwhelmed when I look at my closet. Like, I'm planning to do a 12 by 12, not a 10 by 10, a 12 by 12. And I look at my closet and I can't decide what to take with me because there are so many options. So number four resolution would be to sell, swap, or donate clothes, shoes, and bags that I don't use. If I didn't use it last year during the same season, okay, so if it's like a summer clothing and it's summer now, and I didn't use it last year, and it's just been in like in storage, then that's gonna have to go. Okay, I'm gonna have to reevaluate my fall and winter clothing as well and have a look at like what needs to go. Like, I'm just thinking in my head right now what coats I have, and I have way too many. I've got a coat for every single day of the week and then some, and I don't need that. Okay, I don't need to have, how many trench coats are, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I've got 5 trench coats and then 2, 3 and 4 really thick ones, like wool coats. I don't need 9 coats, especially because it's an outer clothing. I repeat that clothing. If anything, I might need 1 or 2 trenches, like a brown or beige and a black one, and then excuse me, 1 thick coat. That's it. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna have to look at everything that I own. And what I've done with the jeans that I have so many of is actually try them on, and only those that fit me well, regardless of what brand they are, they're the ones that stay. And I'm gonna do the same thing for every item or every category of clothing that I have, because sometimes I find myself holding on to something just because it was expensive, or just because it's a certain brand name. Even though I don't feel comfortable wearing it, it doesn't fit me well, it doesn't look good on me. So those are some things that also have to go. And as I go through those every season, I'm gonna film a video of me decluttering my wardrobe every season so that I can get rid of the things that I don't actually use or wear, okay? And my fifth and final resolution is that it will tie back to item number 3 and number 4, which is, number 3 is to stop shopping, and number 4 is to actually try and sell and recoup some of the money that I've spent on the clothes that I have, okay? It's to save money. Okay? So if I stop shopping, I most likely will save money. And I'm gonna really like evaluate and try to keep a good eye on myself, because I find that when I stop shopping for something, I find another category to spend on. It's a vicious cycle. Like, I stopped buying makeup and then I got into buying clothes. And then I stopped buying clothes and I got into buying bags. So I need to really watch myself, okay? So I'm gonna save, and whatever I'm gonna save, I'm going to put into an investment. Like stock exchange, for example, or real estate, or like bonds, whatever it may be. I'm just gonna have a look at what I am able to save. My goal is to save $1,000 a month. And now that I don't have a credit card to pay up, I think I can do it, okay? Given my current financial situation, I think I can put aside $1,000 Australian every month. And at the end of 2020, I wanna be able to see at least $12,000 in my savings account. So I'm gonna keep you guys updated on that on a monthly basis. I won't tell you how much is in my bank account, but I will tell you whether or not I was able to put in that $1,000 in the bank or in my savings or however I wanted to invest it, okay? So because saving only gets you so much interest, I want to be able to invest and get more out of that. Maybe my next addiction would be watching my bank account grow. Maybe that should be the addiction that I should have. Okay, so that's my plan for 2020. So needless to say, I'm gonna be on a low buy. I'm gonna stop, and I'm gonna also try and recoup some of the money that I've spent on frivolous things that I've bought. Okay, whether they were bought brand new or secondhand. Okay, that's my resolution for 2020. So let me know if you have your own resolutions, as I said, and if you are wanting to join me in my resolutions, please let me know and let's all do it together.